1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, end of test. This Houston, contact with the test 1. Roger, gear lock, clear here.
Welcome to this new episode of the Galactic Chloé Show. Today we are meeting with Pauline Verchinine, an EPFL student from Life Sciences. She was the winner of the EPFL speaking contest last year. Good afternoon, Pauline. How are you doing?
I've got to get out of here.
Calm down. Get a hold of yourself.
Stewardess, please, let me handle this.
Thank you. I'm doing great. So we heard you won the speaking contest at EPFL last year.
Yes, indeed.
What is exactly a speech contest?
Well, if you just look at the theory, it's you're given a subject or a theme, and you have to prepare a speech that you will present in front of an audience and juries. The juries will mainly evaluate not your speech, surprisingly, but the way you deliver it and how you manage to get the audience hooked.
I believe that our education, like such as in South Africa and the Iraq, everywhere like such as, and I believe that they should, our education over here in the U.S. should help the U.S. Or should help South Africa and should help the Iraq and the Asian countries.
And how does the selection work?
At EPFL, we do like a mini contest first for the contestant to really prepare. We give them a 3-minute speech instead of a 6-minute one. We give them questions at the end. And we also give them a little improvisation exercise to see how they will react if we try to step them a bit, just to see if they can handle losing their speech in the middle.
He's killing you! He's killing you!
Must be an original beast.
He's killing you!
And your very first month at EPFL, you apply, you go on stage, and you actually win the competition.
I did.
This is very impressive. What do you think made the difference between you and the other candidates?
Well, at first I was really surprised. I was not expecting at all. I did it just for the experience. I thought it would be nice. But I guess I just tried to merge emotion and theory to bring something to the audience and create a link with them. And it worked pretty well. So I tried to bring them something new about my subject. I said, oh, I made this research, and guess what? And I also tried to say, but look, I'm also someone very relatable. This way it sticks more, and I thought I made a good impression.
Albert Einstein issued one of my most favorite quotes in the history of the spoken word, and it is as follows. In the middle of opportunity, in the middle of difficulty lies opportunity. I'm going to repeat that so I have clarity tonight. In the middle of difficulty lies opportunity.
It was more personal, maybe more authentic.
Perhaps, although many candidates did an amazing job at this. But I guess it was because I shared something that was relatable to a lot of people in the public, which is they were young just like me, and they probably understood what I was talking about.
And do you have any advice or tips for people watching us or even myself to make our speeching skills more
incredible? I can try. I did coach the finalists this year. It was very great. I gave them 3 words, which were presence, confidence, and being memorable.
Easy peasy.
Yes, no. I tried to make it sound easy. It requires work on the three of them. If I were to give you, let's say I give you an example about being confident. Now, when you speak, you don't want to do or am, which a lot of us do all the time. So instead, what I say is you try to say your sentence. Let's say you forget. Instead of dragging it, which gives you the illusion of being in control and talking, just stop and make a blank. If you add the look, people will think you're making a dramatic pose. You're just panicking, but nobody knows it, so that's fine.
Oh, here's my scene,
Mrs. Wallace?
Yes.
I'm Dr. Drake Ramore, your sister's neurosurgeon.
Yeah, tell me, is she going to be all right?
I'm afraid the situation is much more dire than we'd expected. Your sister is suffering from a
Nice touch. I'm looking forward to hearing your speech now. And what was your speech about, actually?
My subject was about happiness. It was a quote from Boris Vian, which is a known writer in France. If I had to roughly translate it, it was, I believe that the happiness of every person is more important than the happiness of the people. So it was individual happiness versus, let's say, collective happiness. And I thought it was a very good subject.
Do you mind if we take a look?
I'll say I wouldn't for this time.
Okay. Okay, here we go.
J'ai grandi en France, et c'est pas la partie triste de l'histoire, ça vient après. Et la voie royale en France, quand vous aimez les sciences et que vous y êtes bon, c'est de faire 2 années de classe préparatoire, voire 3, où vous préparez les concours aux grandes écoles. Les Français verront de quoi je parle, pour les Suisses, peut-être pas, c'est un cursus assez unique en Europe. Pendant ces 2 années, vous serez mentalement mis à l'épreuve. Vous devrez travailler énormément, vous sentirez beaucoup. C'est un cursus où on m'a dit qu'il rendait les gens qui aimaient les sciences heureux. Après, vous ferez ingénieur. Tu verras, Pauline, tu seras heureuse. On m'a dit ça à tout mon lycée. Et tout mon lycée me voilà attendant mes années de classe préparatoire. J'ai fini par me demander, est-ce que j'y serai heureuse? Alors, d'une façon que certains ont trouvé égoïste, j'ai cherché mon bonheur. Je ne voulais pas cette pression, je ne voulais pas cet encadrement, je ne voulais pas de cette France. Alors je suis partie. J'ai cherché, j'ai trouvé le EPFL.
Interesting story there about the French educational system. Why did you choose to shift to the Swiss one?
I decided to leave France because that's not the way I wanted to spend my higher education. The higher education that was proposed to me in France was either university or what's called classe préparatoire, which is very specific to France. It's a very intensive, usually 2 years courses, but most people do a third year because you have so much to learn in 2 years. It's known to be, if I can say this, mentally really tough. And I knew that's not what I wanted for me, especially when it's your first year of higher education and you finally leave high school. I said it was not for me.
You're different.
Not so much if you consider how many French people there are here, but...
Well, that makes me think. You decided to do this episode in English. That is kind of rare for a French person.
That is. And actually, some people don't assume I'm French when I speak English, which I'm very happy when they do that. I did because I think English touches more people. I still prefer French, but English touches more people.
Don't you try the tricks anglais with me, monsieur. I received a message this morning from Inspector Quimland of the Art of Scotland.
The message!
And it was you that gave it to me.
Message!
What?
You mean message?
Look, I know what I mean, you lunatic. Now do you or do you not have for me the message?
So when I left, I faced a strong opposition, especially from my high school teachers, who told me that prépa was kind of the royal way, which it is in France. But internationally, it's not really. They hate to admit it. So when I went to EPFL and I first discovered the campus on a discovery day, it was amazing and I could not let go of the idea of going to EPFL. And I just left.
And how was it the first year at EPFL?
You have to see the wizard, the wonderful wizard of Oz. You find he is a wizard of wiz, if ever a wiz there was. If ever a wizard of wiz there was, the wizard of Oz is one because of the wonderful things he does.
How can I say this? I said I would be, I was lost. That's all. It was confusion and a lot of loss. There was so much to know, so many platforms to know how to log in. I got lost in the campus itself, and then in Lausanne itself. I'm really bad with that. And it was terrible. But then I got the hang of it. And just when I started to like the life, I realized that the studies were so hard. And yeah, that's how I kind of lost a lot on points on my grades.
And how did you shift to life sciences?
I failed my first semester, like many people out there, sadly. And I decided during the second semester, which is called MAN, I decided to really think about my future and my career and what I was doing, because I was really not happy with the first semester. And I realized that I really wanted to do something more practical. I really wanted to go in a lab and I really wanted to work in neurosciences. I always thought I could do this by going through math, but when I had to face the truth that I was not made for this career in complete math, I decided to switch to SV, so that's how I did it during the second semester.
So you went through the famous MAN. What are your thoughts on that?
That's a cool question indeed.
If I have to be polite to EPFL, I would say I gladly recognize their envy to help students. Now, if I can be a bit more critical, I would say there is a lot to improve on, especially that it's really hard to stay hooked the whole semester of MUN, and it doesn't necessarily tackle the reasons why you failed in the first place. But I give them that, they're trying to save the students by every mean, and yeah, thank you for that.
And now, do you think like you find your right fit with life sciences?
I feel perfect in life sciences, and I'm actually enjoying the studies, which is a big difference with last semester, where I was really forcing myself to go to work, so yeah.
I guess we'll see during the exam session. By the way, let's take a look at what's happening today on Earth. As we hit the end of the year 2020, let's go back to this autumn semester at EPFL. New, but not so new, looks like EPFL keeps on going with its new virtual initiatives. But biggest news will be the announcement of the exam session happening soon. Be careful not to miss tonight's 19h30 on the RTS La Première. Breaking news coming up, Martin has some good news for us. Not an easy time, it seems. How is the lockdown going for you?
Well, I would say after almost a year, we're getting used to it. I cannot conceive life outside of lockdown now. I mean, not lockdown complete, but for example, the fact that my classes are online does not surprise me at all. I could not imagine a world where I would have to do like last year and wake up every morning at like 7 to go to class on campus. It seems so weird to me now. So I guess we got used to it. I kind of miss the social interactions, but for the rest, it's fine.
And do you have time to do more hobbies, for instance?
Not really. I'm working a lot recently. I guess online classes requires more of you than usual classes. When I have free time, I just play online or I get on little walks, so I don't really have time to develop a hobby.
And you're also the vice president of the MUN?
Yes, it's what an association.
Yeah, what is it?
The full name is Modern United Nations, so we are a political debate association. We focus a lot on debate and public speaking, which is why we are also the people organizing the public speaking competition.
Any anti-imperialist group like ours must reflect such a divergence of interests within its power base.
Agreed. Francis? Yeah, I think Judith's point of view is very valid, Ray. Provided the movement never forgets that it is the inalienable right of every man
or woman
to rid himself
or herself.
Agreed.
Thank you, brother.
Or sister. Where was I?
And we mostly debate about international politics. MUN is an activity that's known worldwide, so we prepare our members to world conferences. The biggest one is Harvard, with World MUN, and it's supposed to happen at Tokyo. The problem is they have put it online because of Corona and has been reported to next year, again.
So usual.
It's a very nice association and the members are all very, very nice.
So you have many projects. Would you say that through these initiatives, you want to share the message of including more women in STEM, for instance, something more and more present in our generations?
I guess I carry the spirit that was given to me when I was younger. When you're in France, you are very much encouraged as a woman to participate in this activity and show that you can be present and active. Now, it's not one of my main objectives per se, but if it can be one of the side effects, encouraging and like inspiring more women, I would be very glad. And I would gladly help those who would like to pursue it this way.
Did you experience a difference between mathematics and life sciences at EPFL in terms of women percentage?
The first thing that struck me when I arrived in my first class in math was that there was absolutely no woman, nowhere. I mean, there was, when you look attentively, you can see them like somewhere, but it was so non-present. And at first I did not realize it. It's really when I started to search for women just by curiosity, because everybody told me, wow, you're gonna be in math. There's nobody like there. And when I arrived in life science, when it was still in presential, even though it was only 1/3 of the class, we were almost 50%, I think. So it just feels very different. And I couldn't say if it's better or worse, because I don't really attribute value based on that. But I can still say that it's different environment, definitely.
For more fun fact about Pauline, let's look at her logbook, Live from the Moon. Working at home or at the Rolex?
I'd rather work at home.
Sciences or politics?
I think you need both, but if I had to choose, I'd go for sciences.
Sats or tap house?
I can't choose, I'm sorry. I'm panicking. Sat.
We all hope that Sat and Tap House will open up soon enough to celebrate the end of this amazing year. Do you have a message for the students watching us today?
Do you have for me the massage?
Oh, you want a massage, eh?
If you have one for me, yes.
If I could give a message to them, it would be don't be afraid to doubt yourself. I changed section, it's fine. I failed, it's fine. You will make it, we will make it. Good luck.
Beautiful, Pauline. Speaking skills, MUN and EPFL rather than prépa. Have a nice trip back home, safe trip.
Thank you.
Thank you for coming.
Thank you.
We wish you all a very nice end of the year. Hope for the best, 2021 will be better. And if you want to share your homemade memes, as usual, send it to our email address right here.